الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه عباد الله اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذني الله وإياكم من النار. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد, all praise is due to Allah, whom we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from whatever evil our heart conceal and from the consequences of our evil deeds. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants guidance will never be led astray, and whoever He leads astray will never find guidance. And I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His slave, servant and messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in His book, O you who believe, fear Allah as He deserves to be feared, and die not except in a state of Islam, in a state of submission to one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan just left. Ramadan just left, and in Ramadan and during Ramadan, all of us, we were doing our best of best, from the worship, salah, taraweeh, qiyam, Quran, and you name it. And subhanallah, Ramadan by itself has its own taste, subhanallah. The environment of Ramadan by itself, it's the environment of Iman that you will not find it somewhere else, subhanallah. And during this month, many of us, if not all of us, we did our best from the ibadah, from the salah, from the tahajjud, from the qiyam, from the Quran, to get closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And alhamdulillah, many of us, we did that. We felt that closeness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this was during Ramadan. This was only during Ramadan. And subhanallah, as I told you, that you cannot compare that unity that you have in Ramadan. That you come together in Ramadan. You eat together in Ramadan. You pray together in Ramadan. You listen to the Quran in Ramadan at once. Not only that, you all in one time reading the Quran, reading the Salah, and the Imam is saying the Dua, and all of you saying Ameen. Such a beautiful feeling that you feel. But what after Ramadan? What next? This is the question we would like to ask ourselves. that what we did in Ramadan, mashallah, it was something amazing, you can say. But what after Ramadan? In today's khutbah, in few minutes, I would like to share with you advices. These advices for me, before anyone else, and then for rest of the brothers and sisters. And before I come to the advices, I just would like to mention few points, important points. Point number one, brothers and sisters, that everyone knows in Ramadan, Shaitan was locked. Shaitan was chained by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in 1 month, you was doing your best from salah, ibadah, siyam, everything, qiyam. And now, Shaitan is unlocked. And beside that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says something amazing about Shaitan. In many places in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ شَيْطَانَ أَوْ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. Shaitan is your open enemy. Shaitan is a clear enemy to you. Now who's saying that? It's a statement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا, that he is your enemy, but you also take him as an enemy. So you have also green light to be an enemy with who? With Shaitan. So after Ramadan, you are in a battlefield. With who? With your Shaitan. And do you think, respected brothers and sisters in Islam, that after Ramadan, Shaitan will come to you very calmly, very humbly, very normally? La wallah. He will come to you with full strength, with all his strength. He will come to you with his envy that what you did in Ramadan for 1 month, he wants to destroy it in days. So, he is your enemy and take him as an enemy. Deal with him as he is your enemy. Number two, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us to witness the month of Ramadan. And it's such a wonderful blessing that, you know, you witness Ramadan and you do and you invest the real investment of hasanat and al-ta'at and al-ibadat in that month. But look at the tracks and steps of shaitan. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nur, لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. He comes to you, or he will come to you in a very smart way. What he will come to you and he will say, that mashallah. And by the way, all things that I will tell you about shaitan, it's all whispers. It's all in your mind. No one will come to you physically and sit with you and tell you all these things. It's all in between you and in your mind. Thoughts will come. He will just do his waswasa. He will just whisper to you, that's all. So, the thoughts come in your mind that I did best in Ramadan. This Ramadan, you know, subhanAllah, I finished the whole Quran. Some of them, they will say, I finished the Quran twice, thrice. And shaitan will make these ibadah for you that, you know, you are impressed of your own ibadah. You are proud of your own ibadah. And once you think about it, your all deeds are gone like a blink of eye. All your deeds, all Ramadan. Why? Because it's called riya. You're not talking to anyone now. You're not telling anyone that I give sadaqah, I did this, I no, no, no. It's only you're thinking to yourself and you're proud and you're impressed that you did so and so much in Ramadan. And once you think like that, all your ibadah is gone. So be careful from the khutawati shaitan. Point number three. The shaitan will come to you with your weak point. Every one of us make mistake and we commit sin. Imam, Sheikh, Alim, Faqih, normal person, all of us we do mistakes and sins. With the dalil of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Kullu ibn Adam khatta, that all of the children of Adam, they make mistakes. They do sins. So shaitan will come to you with that weak or your weakness. And he will come to you until you do that mistake. And until you fall into that sin. And then Shaitan will do his work. He will come to you and he will tell you, whisper to you, that look what you did to yourself. In Ramadan, Qiyam, Salah. And look at you now, you're doing sin. You're a hypocrite. Allah will never listen to you. Allah will never accept your dua. You call him, you don't call him, Allah will never listen to your dua. He will not respond to your dua, and he will continue and telling you continuously until he will make you what? Depressed. And then you will leave ibadah, and then you continue doing sins. And what the Prophet ﷺ said, all the children of Adam, they make mistakes, they make sins. And the best of them, وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. The best among those who make mistake, those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is our aqidah, this is our belief. What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, that you make mistake, you have a weak point, go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make istighfar. You did some kind of sin, go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for tawbah. Our Rabb is Wadood, is Al-Kareem, Al-Ghaffar, subhanallah. One of the amazing ahadith, hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Ibn Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. Oh Adam, or son of Adam, if your sins fill between the heaven and the earth, and you come back to me asking for the forgiveness, and I will forgive all your sins. Subhanallah. Can you imagine? Your sins between the heaven and the earth. And you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you said, Ya Rabb, ighfirli. Oh Allah, forgive me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. And the hadith is amazing. He will say, Wala ubali. Allahu Akbar. I will not even care. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins between the heaven and the earth, and Allah will not care also about it. Subhanallah. This is our Rabb. This is our belief. So, do not let Shaitan come over you with all these things. The last point, that Shaitan also will give you hope. Hope? What kind of hope? Shaitan will come to you and he will tell you and whisper to you that you did a wonderful job in Ramadan. Ramadan, mashallah, you was dedicated to yourself and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing. I'tikaf, this and that. And he will keep reminding you about all the good deeds. And then he will tell you, you're still young. You still have time. You will live long. You know what? Break. Just give yourself break. And do, Shaitan will never tell you do sins. Shaitan will tell you enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself, look. He will let you to feel the enjoyment. Enjoy yourself. Go do whatever you want to do. Have some enjoyments. And the person will think, yeah, I did a lot of things in Ramadan. Especially youth. And I have a lot of things, especially our youth, you know. They say when I reach 50, 60, I will go for Hajj. When I reach 50, 60, I will make Salah. When I reach 50, 60, I will do this and that. And this is all from Shaitan. What if that person is doing sin because of the whispering of Shaitan, and the Malik al-Maut, the angel of the death, will come and he will take his soul from his body? That person will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that sin. Allahu Akbar. Something serious. So respected brothers and sisters, to keep our iman as it was in Ramadan, and alhamdulillah, inshallah, it is the same till today, we recharge our iman in Ramadan, right? There is a battery in ourselves of iman. We recharge it in Ramadan with ibadah, with ta'ah, with all of the good things. I would like to advise myself and you only five things. Only five things, there are many. But only five things is if we are only taking these five things and doing it continuously, inshallah, your iman will still be at that level. And you will continue till next Ramadan, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So number one, my respected brothers and sisters. Number one, my advice to myself and you, to praying five times a day, on time, in masjid. Simple. 5 times a day, on time, in the masjid. I don't know what happened to the people in Ramadan, mashallah, they are dedicating themselves. Wallahi, we see them in Ramadan in first row, behind the imam, praying. And the first day of Eid, and after that, you will not see them in the masjid anymore. They are good people, they are praying. Where? At home. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, in Surah An-Nur, في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والأيصال رجال رجال سبحان الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about men, who are the men? What's the definition of the men? With a big mustache? With a high tall? With a height? With bulky body? With heavy voice? La wallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said something very easy. Allah said the definition of the man, the one who comes to the masjid and pray. Rijal. Rijal la tulhihim tijaratun wa la bay'un an dhikrillah. Those men, when they come to the masjid, they will not think about their businesses and worldly matters. These are the men Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described. These are the men who came to the masjid, who comes to the masjid and pray. So, my first advice to you, brothers and sisters, 5 times a day in the masjid on time. Advice number 2, dedicate some time for yourself to make dhikr. One of the ulama, one of the mashayikh, said this is the treasure that many people they don't know about. Dhikr. Allah gave us this ummah dhikr that you can do it even in your blanket, in your bed. You are covered to your blanket and you can do the dhikr and you will get the ajr of a shuhada, subhanallah. Only by dhikr. So dedicate some time for yourself, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, before salah, after salah, in between salah. Sit for some time and dedicate yourself for the dhikr. And there are, mashallah, numbers of the dhikr. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, la ilaha illallah. You name them. And all of these dhikr, they have plenty of the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, I know people, they have aim that they will sit in a time and they will do dhikr for 500 times. The number doesn't matter. But they dedicated themselves that they will do dhikr for a certain time. Even though some brothers I saw that they have this electronic counter in their hands. Regardless what ulama said, ulama have different opinion of using the beats, and but these brothers so keen that they want to do a certain level of the dhikr. 500 times, 700 times, 1,000 times, but they want to do in a day. They will not go to sleep until they do their dhikr, subhanallah. And we are unaware of these treasures. So my advice number 2 is what? Dhikr, dedicate some time for the dhikr. Number 3, and this is very important for the brothers and sisters as well. Your companion. Take your companion carefully. Pick your companion, your friend, carefully. In Arabic, we say, as-sahib, sahib. As-sahib means a person, a companion. Sahib with seen means the one who drags. So as-sahib, sahib means the companion or the person who drags. In other meaning that if your companions are good, they will take you and lead you to the goodness. And if they are evil and bad, they will take you to the bad things, even though if you are a good person. So, pick your friends, choose your friends, those who will make you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have friends, they will tell you, let's go to that masjid, we will pray so-and-so with so-and-so sheikh, let's go and do some da'wah work, let's go and do some charity work, be with them and hold of them. But if you have some friends, they will say, let's go to so-and-so mall, let's go and flirt, a'udhu billah, let's go and do so-and-so, tell them, a'udhu billah, I don't want to be with you anymore. Because your friends, these bad friends, they will not take you to the heaven. But in fact, they will take your hand and they will walk you and take you to the hellfire. So pick your friends and think about them, especially the sisters. They are good, they have good intention, but majority of them, they have the good sisters, majority of them, somehow they have those who backbite, those who slander, those who say bad things about the others. And by time, you will find yourself, your sister, or those you know in the family member, they are getting into that track. So, pick good companion to yourself. Number four, that also dedicate some time for dua. Respected brothers and sisters, dua is something amazing. Calamities, problems, disasters, wallahi, everything will go away because of the dua. Even Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that al-qadr, that is already written 15 or 50,000 years back, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created heaven and the earth, the dua can change that qadr, subhanallah. That dua can change that qadr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that dua can change the qadr. So whatever you want from the worldly matters or from the akhirah, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you raise your hand, and it's a direct connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No need for gigabytes or megabytes or terabytes whatsoever. You raise your hand, and it doesn't matter if you're poor or you're rich, if you're an engineer, if you're a clerk, you raise your hand towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you have direct connection with Allah. You ask whatever you want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the more sincere you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens to you more and more. This is the power of dua. The ummah is in calamity. How many times we made dua? Answer to yourself. Number five, that dedicate some time for yourself to read Quran. Because alhamdulillah, we was into Quran in Ramadan. We was into Quran in Ramadan, day night we are praying, we are trying to finish the Quran from cover to cover. But what exactly after Ramadan? We only touch it on weekly basis, on Jum'ah. And I'm sure what I'm talking about, you know. Only on Jum'ah we touch the Quran and we read Surah Al-Kahf. We have to make our link with Quran. Quran is huda, is a guidance. Quran is shifa, is a cure. We have to make our link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His book. And we are just keeping this book away from us. On a weekly basis, we just touch it. So, respected brothers and sisters, just one page on daily basis, it will be enough for you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you by the blessings of reading that one page. So these are the five advices, respected brothers and sisters. There are many, but these are the easiest way or advices that you can apply in your daily life. And inshallah, once you apply them sincerely, you will find the taste of it, and you will find that in your heart. You will find that in your iman. بإذنالله تعالى. أقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله استغفرك. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه مقتدى وعلى أثره مكتفى. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Before I conclude this khutbah, after the conclusion of this khutbah, what will happen? All of you, the brothers and sisters, will stand up, right? And then everyone will greet each other. You will hug each other. You will kiss each other. And this is the time of it, actually. But you know that hugs and kisses and greetings, there are some people that they will miss it. There are some people they will miss it, that you know someone will hug them or kiss them or greet them. And you know who they are? I'm not talking about Syria or Yemen or... They are your family members. Yes, they are your family members. Because somehow, for unnecessary argument, unnecessary situation, you are cut off with your family member. Your uncle, your sister, your brother, some of them, they have this problem with their parents. Do not let this day go away and pass unless you be in touch or you are in touch with your families. Respected brothers and sisters, Silatul Rahim, the family relation, it's so important that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? La yadkhulu al-jannati qati'. Subhanallah. The person who have cut off relation with his family members, he will not enter Jannah. Subhanallah. So your ibadah, your qiyam, your salah, your sadaqah, your tahajjud, whatever you call it, it's in a side, and you are cut off with your family member, it's in a side, and because of that, you will not enter Jannah. All your good deeds will be on hold until you fix that problem. And this is the best opportunity, respected brothers and sisters, that you can call your friends, call your family members, call your aunt, call your sister, whoever you think that you know you are cut off with them because of unnecessary argument or whatsoever. You might tell me that, wallahi, I am actually calling them, they are not calling me. Every time I call them, they see my number and they will not answer my number. Every time I'm good to them and they are bad to me. Always I send them the presents and hadiyah and everything, but they are replying back to me in a worst conditions. I would like to remind myself and you with the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I will conclude with this. It says in Sahih Muslim, Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu narrated that a person came to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, inna li qaraba, I have relatives. I am good to them and they are bad to me. I am kind to them and they are bad to me. I talk to them in the most nicest way and they are talking to me in a bad, harsh way, rough way. What to do? Look what Prophet ﷺ said. You know what? Since they are rude, just do your work. The Prophet ﷺ didn't say that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if you are saying what you're saying, if it's true what you are saying, then you are better than them. And you have support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against them. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. I know that the word, it comes to you sometime like a sharp knife. Sometimes the words comes to you like a bullet. No problem. Because of Allah and because sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you be the better one and you be the good one in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take your phone, take your mobile and message them. Send them email, send them greeting. No harm to just call them and tell them Eid Mubarak. No harm to just call them and say Salaamu Alaikum, I just would like to greet you. Not a big deal. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us straight and on a straight path, the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma azza al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma azza al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma dhilla shirka wa al-Mushrikeen. Allahumma dhilla shirka wa al-Mushrikeen. Allahumma alayka bi'a'da'i al-Din. Allahumma alayka bi'a'da'i al-Din. Allahumma alayka bi'a'da'i al-Din. Allahumma man arada al-Islam wal-Muslimina bisu'in fashghilhu fi nafsih. Waj'al da'iratahu alayhi ya rabbil alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyi'atina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. وادخلنا الجنة يا قوي يا قهار اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. I request all the brothers and sisters to get up and just say salam and greet those who are at the left and right side. جزاكم الله خير.